Welcome back to Inside Rebel Football. It's now time to talk my favorite. That's defensive coordinator Tony Osborne here with us. And Coach, why don't you go ahead before we get going, introduce your guest tonight.
Defense is our favorite as well,
that's
Rick.
Right.
It's the exciting part of the game to us. I brought two seniors, defensive backs. They both play safety in the secondary. Number four in the program and number one in your heart, Jadis Richard. And number two in the program and number one in your heart, Jack DeBrule. Jack plays strong safety for us, and Jadis plays free safety.
Welcome to the show, guys. Appreciate you being here. Coach, let's start with your assessment of the defense against Neville. We'll talk about the defense in general here in a second. I just want to know what you think. After you had a chance to look at film against Neville, how did the defense do?
Well, you know, Rick, going into the game, our goal was to become a little more physical, get more players running to the football, and I thought we accomplished that. We still got some lineup issues and some gap issues, you know, people going in the wrong gaps, which are very fixable things and usually at the beginning of the year, you're going to have those issues. But overall, I felt like defensively they came to play, and I was pleased, not disappointed at all the way they played.
You and I talked before the Jamboree. We talked about the scrimmage. You said there was trouble tackling, and you went back to say it had a lot to do with how we practiced, because we were missing tackles because maybe we weren't going to the ground at practice. What changed at practice this past week?
Well, I think the whole staff agreed with that assessment, and Coach Arledge and I talked about it and some of the other coaches, and we just felt like we needed to put the pants on and just get after it and make the quarterback live and unless he was in the pocket so our kids could scrimmage per se.
Sure.
I feel like sometimes in practice when we're in shorts and we don't want kids to go to the ground, defensively it hurts more than it does offensively, because offense is still going full speed, but defensively we're pulling up, we're tagging people on the butt like we would have had them.
Mm-hmm.
And I think I think that's a little bit of our fault, but we Monday and Tuesday after that Thursday scrimmage, we put pants on, we went out, and we got after it. And I think it was good for our kids, and I think it's something we need to continue to do. And we put the pants on yesterday and did a little bit of it, but just not as hard.
Yeah. Jadis, when you showed up at practice that day and they said, put the pants on, what went through your head? Was it something that you said, okay, yeah, I agree with this, we're ready to go? Or it's like, oh, man, we got to put the pants on? What's going on? What was your thought?
I mean, we kind of already knew about it, because Sunday they kind of got on us about us missing tackles. So Monday, I mean, we was kind of expecting it. Like, we really wanted to do it anyway. So, yeah.
Jack, how did practice go once you guys started really scrimmaging and going to the ground? Could you tell a difference in the performance and the intensity of practice?
For sure. The pants was a great idea, in my opinion. It got us more aggressive, and I think 100% it got us better. And I like doing it.
Jack, you're a new face, a new name on defense this year. Got some action in the Bayou Jam against Neville. What's that been like? What's it been like being a senior leader on this defense? Take me through that.
Man, it's been a blessing. Senior year is a big deal to me. And, really my goal was just to put 100% effort in anything. And, I'm blessed by T.O. and Jadis and all the defense letting me on the team, coaching me up and, walking me through it. And I've been really blessed by it.
That's awesome. Jadis, you've had an eventful offseason. A lot of folks, a lot of our viewers, a lot of our listeners have been following you as a recruit throughout the offseason. You land in Fort Worth at TCU. Tell me, kind of take us through, let us in a little bit on that process. What made you land there?
I didn't ever took no visit. Like, my only visit I took was to Louisiana Tech.
Uh-huh.
And, I just, like, when everything shut down in July, the last week of July, I opened back up, and I had already planned on, taking a visit that Thursday to TCU, and mm-hmm. I knew I wanted to commit before the season, so I had already dropped my top three down to Baylor, Louisiana Tech, and TCU, and kind of when I went on the visit, it kind of just did it, like,
yeah. So you felt like you fit there, the coaches?
Yeah, like, I mean, they basically run like the same defense that we run now. So it's not like it's anything changing in college.
Yeah. Did you feel any pressure the first performance in the Bayou Gym? Did you feel any pressure as, hey, look, there's a lot of folks watching me. I got some expectations now. I'm a D1 commit. Did you feel any pressure?
Oh, no. I went out there with no pressure. No pressure. And nothing was on my mind. I was locked in.
I was ready to play. Coach, you have these two guys here. You've got a lot of talent in that secondary this year. Tell me about some of the other guys that we can look for this season.
Well, you know, we also have Rayshon Pleasant, who's committed to Louisiana Tech as a cornerback. And, you know, he's going to split time at some running back in the secondary still. But when he's not over there at the cornerback position, we have number 5, Javari Sanders, who played a lot for us last year. And number 6, Paul Manning, who also started and played a lot. They both started and played a lot last year because, you know, Rayshon wasn't with us last year.
Right.
And so they've got a year of starting under their belt and they're back. So we've got three pretty good corners right there.
Mm-hmm. Coach, you've talked about, you know, the depth in the secondary. Do you think that's going to be an issue maybe across the board, not just in the secondary, but across the team and maybe other teams that you play? A lot of folks didn't get to play freshman and JV football last year.
Right.
Have you seen that, or maybe were we a little behind when the season started, as you know, we didn't get the reps that we're used to getting last year?
Well, I don't know if we're behind, because I'm assuming everybody had the same issue last year. But I do see, and this is you know, doesn't happen every year. You know, most years I can kind of see backups and people that could play right now, but I'm not seeing the depth that I'm normally seeing. So we're just going to have to keep developing it a little bit each week and get those other guys some reps so that if there comes a need, you know. And I tell the safeties all the time that there's 3 positions, and it's going to take more than 3. It's going to take about 6 of them to play and get through the season. So, you know, we got to keep developing that depth. And then, you know, over on the weak side, safety, we have A.J. Howard, who was a running back last year, and Hunter Myers, who was a weak safety last year, playing that position. And I feel like those two are pretty settled in. And depth-wise, you know, they can spell each other. I'm still trying to find some for everybody else.
Yeah. Guys, you hear about, hey, the lack of development, these guys didn't get reps. Is that something that the coaches have put on you as now as seniors, your leaders? Your leaders, is that have you taken that on, Jadis? Is that something you take personal now? Like, look, this is my responsibility in 2021.
Yes, sir. I mean, in practice, like, even any chance I get, I mean, I try to help people with their craft, try to help people with their technique. I mean, just like the other day, I told him some more steps to help him get better at his off man, and it helped.
Yeah.
So, I mean, being stepping up to take the leadership role, I mean, I feel like that was something I needed to do my senior year in order for us to make a deep run and come together like as a team.
Yeah. Well, looking forward to calling the games, guys. Jack, Jadis, best of luck to you. Coach, always
Thank
a pleasure
you.
Visiting with
Appreciate
you.
Appreciate you, Rick.
I wish you the best of luck, and we'll see you Friday.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. All right, when we come back, we'll have a chance to look at some highlights from the Jamboree against Neville. I'll have Coach Tony Osborne and Coach Joey Adams will narrate through those highlights. We'll be right back.